Hello, so the recording stopped. I don't know where it stopped, but I'm working on soldering a vesk. So I just cut the cables that I will use. I actually already soldered most of the parts. I'm just doing the wires. So we need this here. So this one should be good. I think this one should be good. Now actually, that's a lot of work to do. There's a lot of work to do on the vesk. It's way cheaper, that's true. But there is it does take a bit of time. I mean, it's not that much. Maybe, you know, a few hours. But still, to get everything to work the right way. And then you have some uncertainty as well. Because you are not sure that everything will work as expected. I have one version of the device, not one version, one copy of the device that's not working, and I don't know, have no idea what the problem might be. Even less knowing that the other one works. So exactly the same. From the same batch. I mean, I probably did something wrong, but I don't know what. Perfect. Negative, positive. Now, this might be too short. I'll make a longer one. This was the best idea ever. I bought this. I think 10 meters, 2 times 10 meters of cable. So this is a 12 AWG, or is it pronounced differently? did that. So, on the other version, I did it on the other side, but that's a bad idea because because we'll have a heatsink on the other side. So now I need to fix this. I will see if I can just. Maybe I will have two heat sinks like this. Yeah, maybe that's what I will do. Otherwise, I don't know how. Yeah, otherwise, I don't know how I can manage this. We'll see. For now, I'm not planning on using them at their maximum. Anything or anything close to it. Okay, this looks good. This looks good. One last. I hope that it's still recording. And on this part, I'm done. So now we need to... Sorry. We need to put this. These connectors. So the female ones. And also need this. So let's do this. So what I'm doing is I need to have this small hole pointing up. Then if it works as expected, that's not how I've done it the first time. I put the tip of the soldering iron inside.
or put up enough to be able to fill it with solder. Once it's filled, kept the tip there. And voila. Perfect. Just need to produce this. I don't know if this is the right technique, but this works very well. Where is the last third? It probably fell. Okay, probably fell on. So the last one. Plus is on the side. I will try to apply the same strategy, but I'm not sure this will work as well as the two other times. So let's see. And usually it's very hard to fix if it doesn't work well. It doesn't stick for some reason.
I forgot hitting. But that's not too much of a worry since I can put it on this one.
And I forgot to I will have a very hard time severing it for some reason, I don't know why. It doesn't stick, it doesn't keep. It's like you're peeling. Do I need some flux? Maybe some flux will help. Where is my flux? No, it doesn't work. Or it does. It does work. Very nice. So now I know how to fix the other one. We should be done with the soldering iron. Now we need the heat gun, the rework station. So it's -2, -2. Okay, then we need something like this. For here, that's why it's not too much of a problem when I forgot the heatsink around the red wire. Because I can still manage it. I Nice. Now we need to do the same thing around this. Too tight. Perfect. There is one last thing we need to fix, which is the USB port. So we need to unsolder this and then solder it on the other side, because it doesn't work otherwise. So for this, perfect. Now I basically need to do the opposite on the other side. Perfect. And we are done. We need to check one last thing. And for this we need the microscope, which I would just like to check that. There are no shorts.
Let's power this on with a voltage limiting power supply. Here it is. So at 5 volts, limited at 100 milliamps, and if everything works, it shouldn't short. Perfect. You can see a small LED here. Now we need to flush it. For this, we need the power supply, the battery, which is here. We need, I'm not sure if I did something wrong, we need the ST link too. So let's do this. The first one is the 3.3 volt. So here, 3.3 volt VCC. Then the second one is the yellow, is reset. Reset. The violet one is the clock here. The green one is SW, this something, and the blue one should be the ground. It is the ground. And now we plug this to the USB port, power it on, and flush it with the right firmware. Let's see if we can flush it from here. ST-Link. Disconnected, can we connect? Here, connect. Yes, there is a device detected. Actually, powering it on before was a bad idea. I have to wait. It was a very bad idea, because it might turn on some pins that are not supposed to be turned on. So open desktop, dump to download the So we need to download this. Download the zip. No. And then desktop temp. Maybe CFOC2. I'm not sure. I think I should be doing this on this branch. Perfect. Now we open this firmware latest and we need to flush it, so open CFOC2 developer branch firmware latest. We need the hex and we need to flush. Everything goes as expected. As soon as this is done, we should be able to read. I can already open this tool. Done. Perfect. So I will unplug the ST-Link, plug the USB cable, connect it using the USB port. And hope for the best. It does seem to work. This is very nice. So I can go to firmware. You can see that everything looks good for now. Now we will plug the brushless motor. It. Welcome setup wizard, medium out runner, next, yes, 2.2 ampere hours resell, next, run detection. Nice! We can hear the calibration routine. You can see it rotate. Nice! So this is how you do it on how you flash your VESC, and you can watch the other video to know how to solder it. And yeah, basically that's it. Perfect. And now I can, yeah, you can. So if you set this up on a skateboard or something, you can change the rotation. So how is it called? Yeah, you can change the direction, rotation direction, just by switching this. Yeah, I wanted to show you one last thing. So here you can see the motor. If I click here, you can spin it both ways. Very nice. I wanted to check something. I wanted to check if we can see, if we can see the current. Real-time data, current, nice. Somehow it doesn't show up. Okay. I hope this was helpful. Bye.